30, and the other one is talking about the case, but somehow the I haven't found any solutions. I mean, at least direct solution to answer the problem in case 7. Yeah. Okay. So anyway, let's try to finish the chapter 13 first. Okay. Last time we were talking about the aggregate planning. Aggregate planning is considered as the mid-range planning. Somehow you like sitting in the dark. Okay. So mid-range planning is another terminology, so-called intermediate range planning. If the long range is over 1 year, like capacity planning, facility planning, and product development, and so on. Okay. So intermediate plan is 3 to 18 months, and then short range is daily life within 3 months. So let's talk about the Apple company, for example. Apple company renamed the company names. From Apple Computer Company to Apple Company in the year of 2000. So, why is that? Apple Company was Apple Computer Company before 2000. Any observation? Well, maybe 2000 is too old for you. Okay. Actually, in the 1990s, at least in the middle of 1990s, in the industry, they were talking about what were the differences between the computer industry and the communication industry. Okay. So let's try to think about what are the major differences between the computer and communication industries. For something.
You mean by 2000?
No. Or even at this moment, still hold. Talking about not technology, talking about the business.
Business.
Yeah, business. This is a business school, right?
Mm-hmm. I think computer industry is part of communication industry.
Not really. Just try again. I was talking about the business, right? What kind of business relationship for these two industries with the consumers or their customers? There's a hint.
Maybe like in communication industry, maybe they need more emotion, feelings, the customer.
Well, that's maybe a piece of it.
Product.
No. Okay. That's my answer. All right. So whenever we bought a computer, okay, the relationship with the sellers or the manufacturer ended. after we fulfill the payment, right? How about the communication? We bought a service and then pay continuously. Right?
Post service.
Yeah, you see, we bought this because the communication is kind of a service we bought, okay, for a certain period of time. So we pay the money to the communication industry from time to time. You know, that's how computer industry design. They design for this one. Okay? Right? So the deal is only once. Okay, who sell the smartphone? Who are the sellers selling the smartphone? Service provider. Okay, service provider, you see? They try to utilize the selling to bridge with the consumer's usage, right? Okay, before 2000, Apple company selling their computers only, all right? Okay, so what were the major products for Apple company in 2000? No. I mean, as a communication.
iPad.
You see? iPad is very similar. I mean, the function of iPad is very similar to the product back to the 1980. Walkman, right? But Walkman, they are selling the Walkman, and then has no relationship with the consumers, right? iPad, but if we had the iPad, we need to download the songs, right, from the website. You see? Yeah. So Apple companies start building up the relationship with the consumers all the time, starting back to the 2000. Okay, so Apple changed the computer industry to combine the communication into it. But however, how many companies were able to do that, even for today? Okay, Google, after they bought the design team from HTC, okay? Now they are selling their own, now they are selling their own design cell phone, right? And Asus, two major computer companies, they are selling their computers and cell phone and even build up the cloud for consumers. The consumer really utilize their cloud. You see? Interesting. You see? So if we put the long-range plan for the Apple company, right, in the year of 2000, it's changed their format from pure computer company to bridge into the communication world, okay? Then what is the intermediate range plan for them? Well, slightly long from iPad to iPhone. And then every year they need to release a new iPhone, right? So it's like 3 to 18 months, okay? 3 to 18 months. Okay. So let's think about what is so-called output is aggregate plan. For example, within 3 to 18 months, how many iPhones is going to sell? Would the Apple company know exactly the size of the volume? Well, probably. But how about the very scale of the iPhone sales volume? It's very hard to measure, right? So for the aggregate number, how many iPhones? Maybe for the new iPhone is 100 million units, plus the old ones may be over the 200 million per year. But it's hard to tell which part. Okay? It's hard to tell which part. So that's so-called aggregate. That's so-called aggregate. Okay, like Toyota, okay, you know the maybe the top two automobile manufacturing companies in the world. One is Toyota, making more than 10 million cars every year. So why is the one of the two, the other one of the two? What? Volkswagen. You know, the if you have ever been to the mainland China, their taxis are all Volkswagen. Volkswagen. So it's also over 10 million per year. Okay? So can you tell what kind of type of automobile they are selling every year? Even themselves, they cannot make sure. Okay? So they may classify the cars into different layers. For example, sedan, small sedan, like less than like the size of engine is less than 2,000 cc. Okay, maybe classed as the lowest part. Okay, the one between the 2,000 to 3,000, that's so-called maybe like close to the fancy one. Okay, so somehow for example, the Toyota will what build up another brand name, so-called what? Lexus, to build up another type of the car, okay? Okay, maybe even more than 3,000 cc, okay? 3,000 cc, okay? So they may try to make a forecast based on the group of the car, not the individual ones, not the individual ones, just like iPhone. So decision must be tied to strategic planning and integrate with all areas of an overall planning horizon. So sales and operation planning is aimed at the coordination and integration of the internal and external resources necessary for a successful everyday plan. Because of what? For more than 10 million car manufacturing within a year, we got to think about the raw material and components and so on, right? Even somehow before what? Before design phase, right? For example, why the iPhone would like to start design their new iPhone 16 months before what? Release, because of the raw material. They got to think about the most advanced components, try to merge into their new ones. Yeah. So it's spending time. Which implies what? iPhone 13 design is almost there. Yeah. Almost finished design. Almost finished design. Okay. So they were built up the pylon for manufacturing around at the beginning of a year. And then they were what? Set up the assembly lines no later than June. Then they will start the mass productions during the summer. Yeah. You see, all processes need to be integrated. So then they need a logical unit for measuring sales and output. What is the logical unit? For example, the Foxconn will build up the what? The largest size of the iPhone. then Pegatron will build up the smaller ones. Because of the labor training and the material supply and so on, okay? Okay, so a forecast of the demand for a reasonable intermediate planning period in aggregate terms. A method to determine the relevant cost. What would be the relevant cost? I just said about the training, workforce training, or the procurements, or locating the supplier, and so on. A model that combines forecast and cost, so scheduling decision can be made for planning period. So the objective of aggregate planning is to meet forecast demand while minimizing costs over the planning period. Over the planning period. So what is normal length for the planning period? 3 to 18 months, again. Depends on different industries. So this is an example for this kind of machine. This is for what?
More
for garden, right? So what would be the similar ones? Just no. For what? Actually, we can change the wheel to be bored, right? Become the one. Skinny machine, right? But in this case, for example, we have six pile of the mall machine. Okay, then based on the forecast, actually the forecasting is based on the aggregate unit. So this is aggregate unit. It despite the type of the machines. Just focus on the aggregate machine, consider as one, only one. So in January, we will have 150,000. February, 120,000. And March is 110,000, and so on. For the next 3 quarters. Okay. So combine appropriate resources into general term. What would be the appropriate resources? Human resources is one of them. Okay. Part of the larger production planning system. Certainly. The purpose for forecasted demand is by trying to build up the machines to fulfill the orders. Okay. So then as time close by, okay, then what? Within 3 months. So we need to disaggregate those aggregate units into the physical product, the precise products to build up. So this aggregation breaks the plan down into greater detail. So this aggregation results in the master production schedule. That's within three months. So next chapter, we will talking about material requirement planning and the master production schedule. So that's a 3 months schedule. Okay. So aggregate planning strategy. Should inventory be used to absorb changing demand? That's one of the options. Or what? Or wait until demand occurs. There's a so-called back order, or what was that? The scarcity, right? There's able to use the scarcity strategy for their new seller from all the time. Okay, so change be accommodated by varying the size of the workforce. Should part-timers be used, or should overtime or idle time absorb fluctuations? For example, Amazon, they will hire thousands of part-time workers during the Thanksgiving, before the Christmas, and so on. thousands of the workers, part-time workers. Should subcontracting contractors be used and maintain a stable workforce? So how to maintain the stable workforce through subcontractor? What is the meaning of the subcontractor? They will provide the service only during the peak season for a company, right? So should prices or other factors be changed to influence demand? Okay, you see the iPhone is the new iPhone is always extremely expensive. Now it's more than like $12,000, right? Okay. So capacity option. One is changing inventory label. If the demand fluctuates in the seasonal patterns during the off season, manufacturing process will be kind of busy, right? For example, I just told you for the iPhone, they will build up the inventory during the summer, okay? Not selling the cell phone yet, okay? And here, normally in September, this year is in October, okay? Release their new iPhones. So they spend about 2 to 3 months to build up the inventory. Okay? So normally how many units they are building up? Normally is 50 million to 60 million. You know the what is how many units of iPhones would be carried by a standard container? Yeah, a standard container is so-called the 20-foot container. We can see that there's container cars on the street, right? The longer one is so-called the 40 feet. Okay, the shorter one is around the 20 feet. So one container may contain what? 600,000 units. And what is the size of cargo fleet? Okay, would able to contain 13 standard containers. So we may times what? 600,000 times 13 is close to what? 8 million, right? So how many flights will be taken to move the what? 50 million. So 50 million divided by 8 million. About 6 to 7 aircraft, cargo aircraft. Normally they will let about 6 UPS aircraft standing by. Yeah. Before, just maybe like 3 to 5 days before the what? New product release. You see, so 6 aircraft will be enough to move on. 50 million units of iPhone. So increased cost associated with the storage, insurance, handling excellence, privilege and the capital investment. So shortage may be mean lost sales due to the long lead time and poor customer service if the product is not unique. The other option is varying workforce size by hiring or lay off workers. So match production rate to demand. training and separation costs for hiring and laying off the workers. So new workers may have lower productivities. Okay. But the thing I told you, the mirror of the Taiwanese manufacturing system is what? We may be able to what? Decompose the extremely sophisticated production system into what? Smallest components, right? So that will be reduced the workforce training. Okay, to speed up the what? Manufacturing speed process. So varying production rates through overtime or idle time allows constant workforce may be difficult to meet large increase in demand. Okay. Overtime can be costly. So in Taiwan, the overtime pay is 30% more. For the first, for the first 4 hours or so, okay, and then after that is another 30% more. That would be like 69% more of the normal wage, of the normal wage. So how about the overtime pay in Indonesia or in Vietnam? Oh, I heard about that. Vietnam, the government policies ask those manufacturing from foreign countries need to increase the salaries 7% per year. Yeah. Have you ever heard about that? 7% per year, yeah. Absorbing idle time may be difficult because, for example, for this COVID-19, for travel agents and hotel and so on, especially the hotels in Taipei City, because of the most important customer for those hotels are foreign. So now, because of foreign is not coming, so they are just desperate. So they have serious problem for this idle time smoothing. Yeah. But for Hualien, because this city, okay, filled with the not foreigner at this moment is filled with the Taiwanese because they have no way to go. Okay. So think about this way. Do you know why the tourism industry inside the islands at this moment is booming. Okay, let's think about that. We have like more than 1 or 2 million tourism going outside Taiwan, right? Now they are nowhere to go, so they are spending the money inside the Taiwan. For example, since I'm living in Hualien during the summer, my family went to Taipei City. Okay, I just told them, you may just ignore about the expenses because of what? They so originally I planned to go to some other countries. So my budget is way too big, yeah. It's the same issue for Hualien at this moment. So varying production rates through overtime, idle time. Subcontracting, temporary major during periods of peak demands may be costly. Assuring quality and timely deliveries may be difficult. Okay, use a part-time worker. Demand option. How would be the demand option? Use advertising, promotion, selling, or price cuts. You know, that right before the Apple released their new phones, the old ones, the cost is what? The price is going down, right? The price is going down. So attempt to shift demand to slow pills, okay, may not be sufficient to balance demand and capacity. So how the Apple and the Foxconn together to smoothing this problem? Okay, they released normally the Apple will release their iPhone in September, right? And release their iPad in what? In June or February, smoothing the manufacturing. Also smoothing the what, design, the load of the design team for Apple itself. Agree? Yeah. And also for you know, we have the so-called, we just passed about Alibaba's day, like the 11th of the November, right? Why they pick up the day? Because the Chinese New Year is normally appear at the end of the January, right? So they what? Try to smoothen the requirements. The same for Amazon. Amazon Prime Days copy the idea from Alibaba, okay? So Prime Day normally will schedule in the middle of July. But this year is in October, okay, because of the COVID-19 again. So back ordering during high demand period. Back order is very hard to achieve this idea because the consumer need to wait. So it requires customer to wait for an orders without loss of goodwill or orders. Most effective when there are few, if any. Let's talk about the uniqueness of the product and uniqueness of the service. Actually, you know what? Today's case, Miss Cartoon. You know what is the label of News Cartoon? Uniqueness. I haven't seen any discussion related to this point from your answers. Uniqueness. Often result in lost sale. So counter season product and service mix. What is the most important counter season product in Taiwan?